Asking the questions, Siddhartha Basu.
Hello and welcome to University Challenge on BBC World. Last week we found our fourth quarter-finalist of this year's championship when IIT Madras beat Faculty of Law, Delhi University. It's quiz time again and we're geared up for another second round match. This week's playoff is between two engineering colleges who'll be locking horns for a place in the quarterfinals. From Delhi, we have the Indian Institute of Technology, who posted a sweeping victory over the College of Engineering Trivandrum, totaling a score of 190 and winning by a huge margin of 165 points, 190 to 25. The opponents in that match had no answer to their blitz on the buzzer and bonuses. This time around, the competitors aren't quite pushovers, but they'll be looking to hold on to their winning form. Let's meet the team from IIT Delhi.
Hi, I'm Akshat. I am from Delhi. And my only regret is that life doesn't come with a control Z option.
Hello friends, I'm Pushan from Delhi. I was a part of the IIT Delhi team for University Challenge last year. And after our dismal performance then, I stopped looking at BBC for an year. So hopefully I'll get over my phobia through this year's performance.
And our captain.
Hi, I'm Arna from Bihar. I'm a huge movie buff. My favorite filmmakers are David Lynch and the Coen brothers. And my friends call me the psycho.
Hi, this is Ankur Kothari from Delhi. Among my many positions of responsibility, I'm also the president of the Britney Spears Hate Club of IIT Delhi.
And that's the team from IIT Delhi. Squared up against IIT Delhi, we have the Rashtriya Vidyalaya College of Engineering, or RVCE, from Bangalore, who, after taking an early lead, lost out to the National Institute of Technology, Calicut, in a first-round match, 135 to 110. But qualified for this stage by being among the four best losers. This is one of the two qualifying teams this year with a girl member on board. Although she says her violin playing drives down the real estate price, in her neighborhood, she's definitely driven up her team's score. Who will be collectively looking to gain a winning edge in this round? Let's meet the team from RVCE, Bangalore.
Hi, I'm Siddharth Shankar from Bangalore. Right now, I'm reading Robert Musil's Man Without Qualities.
Hi, this is Aditya Jalat. I'm eagerly waiting for Guy Ritchie's next movie. And sometimes I really wish I had Calvin's transmogrifier.
And their captain.
Hi, I'm Abhishek from Bangalore. In the future, I would love to be an entrepreneur. I belong to a team called Tonic. And we would love to thank our seniors at RV Quiz Corp for all the fun days.
Hi, I'm Ashanka Idia from Bangalore. I love the works of Michael Ondaatje. And the one job I covet the most is Jeremy Clarkson's on Top Gear.
And that's the team from RVC Bangalore. Team, you're familiar with the rules. There, as always, starter questions worth 10 points to be answered on the buzzer without consultation. A correct answer on a starter fetches a team 3 bonus questions worth 5 points apiece, which may be answered by consultation. That's all there is to it. At the final bell, whoever has more points is the winner. So, best of luck, teams. Fingers on the buzzer. Here's your first starter for 10. What is the Indian equivalent of the Red Arrow of the Royal Air Force and the Thunderbird of the US Air Force? It's Aditya from RVC Bangalore.
Surya.
You want to specify that a little more?
Surya Kirin.
I'm going to give that to you. Well done. 10 points. And so that fetches your team bonus questions on code names of military operations. What name was given to the Allied landings in Normandy during the Second World War?
Operation Overlord.
Correct. 5 points. During the Second World War, what was referred to as Utah, Omaha, Gold, Juno, and Sword?
The landing beaches at Normandy. Landing beaches.
Yes, it's the 5 beaches on the coast of Normandy. I'll accept that. Next. What planned military operation that never took place during the Second World War was codenamed Operation Sea Lion?
Sea Lion, Japan.
The invasion of Japan.
No, it's a planned German invasion of Britain. You have 20 on the board. Here's the next starter for 10 for both teams. Which flightless birds of the family Apterigidae are classified as Apteryx australis? And it's Pushan from IIT Delhi.
Kiwi.
That is correct. 10 points. You get a set of bonus questions, IIT Delhi, linked by a color. The plants I. sumatrana and I. arecta were once an important source of which natural dye?
Indigo.
Correct. 5 points. Where in Bihar did Mahatma Gandhi lead his first Satyagraha campaign in India on behalf of oppressed indigo growing peasants?
Champaran.
Champaran is the correct answer. Another 5 points. Which rare metal of silvery white luster is named after the presence of a predominant indigo spectral line seen in its spectroscopic analysis?
Iridium.
It's not iridium, it's indium, which is the correct answer. So, missed one, both teams missed one of their bonuses, but they're both absolutely level at 20 points apiece. Here's the next starter for 10. Which indigenous game received its first international exposure in 1936 when the sports organization... Yes, it's Siddharth who's gone for it. RVC Bangalore. It's an interruption. Must get it right.
Kabaddi.
Kabaddi is the correct answer. Well done. That happened when a sports organization, the Hanuman Vyayam Prasarak Mandal, demonstrated it during the 1936 Berlin Olympics. So, Siddharth, that fetches your team, RVCE. Bonus questions on islands. How do we better know Homo erectus, the first known fossils of which were discovered by E. Dubois in 1891 on an Indonesian island?
Java man.
Correct, 5 points. The Tanjavur inscription of the Chola dynasty dating to 1050 AD describes which island as Nakkavaram or land of the naked?
Ceylon or Sri Lanka?
No, it's Nicobar, which is the correct answer. Next. Which island located in Upper New York Bay was officially known till 1956 as the Bedloe's Island after Isaac Bedloe, who had bought it in the 17th century?
Island of
Statue. The island on which the Statue of Liberty is set.
Called what?
Ellis Island.
It's not Ellis Island, it's Liberty Island, as a matter of fact, after the Statue of Liberty. So can't give you points for that. Well, that's three cycles of questions up. Let's take a quick glance at the scores at this stage. IIT Delhi have 20 on the board. In the lead with 35, it's RVC Bangalore. And it's a visual round now. Clue coming up on the screens in front of you. Fingers on the buzzer. Here it is. Who is this person who served in the US Navy during the Vietnam War? Ashanka from RVC Bangalore.
John Kerry.
John Kerry, the US presidential candidate, is correct. 10 points. You get a set of bonus questions, RVC Bangalore, on decorations. Identify this award established in 1950 by the President of India.
It's the Paramvir Chakra.
That is correct. 5 points. Identify this award, the highest military award of Pakistan.
Nishan-e-Kaz.
No, it's the Nishan-e-Haider, which is the correct answer. Next. Identify this award instituted in 1856.
This is the Victoria Cross.
This is the Victoria Cross. Another 5 points. Well done. You're 55, RVC Bangalore. Here's the next start over to both teams on the buzzer. Which community of Hindus in Rajasthan follow the 29 principles of living established by Jambhoji? And it's Arnab from IIT Delhi.
The Bishnois.
Bishnois is the correct answer. That's right. Bishnoi literally 29. And so Arnav, you fetch IIT Delhi bonus questions on brothers in cinema. What is the surname of the brothers Shyam and Tulsi who produced the films such as Guest House, Purana Mandir and Dak Bangla?
Ramsey.
The Ramsey brothers is the correct answer. Next. Under what banner did Baldev Raj Chopra's younger brother start making his films after breaking away from his brother's production house in the 1970s?
Yashraj Films.
Yashraj Films is the correct answer. Next. Which brothers with the first names August and Louis received a piece of advice from their father who had seen a kinetoscope try to get the image out of the box?
Lumiere brothers.
It is the Lumiere brothers. Well done. You maxed that cycle. Well done. Just 10 points separating the two teams at this stage. Here's the next starter for 10. Which food item gets its name from the Italian word meaning cord? Uncle from IIT Delhi. You went for the buzzer. That was an interruption. Have to get it right otherwise.
Pizza.
Sorry?
Pizza.
It's not a pizza. 5 points taken away from your score. I'll complete the question for the other team. Which food item gets its name from the Italian word meaning cord or string? And it's Ashanka from RVC Bangalore.
Spaghetti.
Spaghetti is the correct answer. Well done. Two of those questions are on Indian Magsaysay Prize winners. Who was the first Indian to be awarded the Magsaysay Prize in 1958 for community leadership?
Deshpande.
No, it's Acharya Vinoba Bhave. Next. In the Peace and International Understanding category, other than Lakshmi Narayan Ramdas, Jokin Arputham, Henning Holt Larsen, and Wealthy Fisher, who has received the honor?
Mother Teresa.
That is correct. You got 5 points. There's only one instance of two Indians holding the same office receiving the award for outstanding government service. Who are they? Name both for points.
Kiran Bedi and KPS Gill.
No. It's T.N. Session and J.M. Lingdo, which is the correct answer. Both were chief election commissioners. Here's the next start of 10, open to both teams. Which hill range in southern India, famous for the iron ore deposits in its vicinity, gets its name from the appearance and its uncle from IIT Delhi?
Nilgiri.
No, that's another interruption gone wrong. That's 5 points taken away. I'll complete the question for the other team. Which hill range in southern India, famous for the iron ore deposits in its vicinity, gets its name from the appearance of its peak that looks like a horse's face? Ashanka from RVC Bangalore.
Kudremukh
is the correct answer. 10 points. Ashanka is plucking them off for our team. Plucking on the violin string seems to help. Bonus questions on a queen. Which queen, whose title meant goddess loving her father in Greek, jointly ruled her kingdom successively with her two brothers and her son?
Cleopatra.
That is the correct answer. Next. Cleopatra's son Ptolemy XV was better known by his by name, which was related to his father. What was Ptolemy XV better known as?
His father was Marcus.
Yeah, the answer.
Marcus Aurelius.
It's not. It's Caesarian. His father was Julius Caesar. Next. The best epitaph on Cleopatra is that of the historian Dio Cassius. She captivated the two greatest Romans of her day, and because of the third, she destroyed herself. Name all the three Romans.
Julius Caesar.
Yes.
Mark Antony.
Yes.
And Octavius.
Octavian. I'll accept that. Octavian or Augustus Caesar. Correct. Well done, you pick up 5 points over there. And with that, it's time to take a break. And at the halfway point of this pre-quarterfinal match of University Challenge, this is how the scores read. IIT Delhi have 35 on the board, but in the lead with 90 is Rashtriya Vidyalaya College of Engineering, Bangalore. That's the way things turned in the second round match of University Challenge, but things could change radically in the second half, as we've seen so often in this contest. Let's find out what happens in that second half after a very short break. Till then, stay with us. Welcome back to the second round match which we are playing between IIT Delhi and RVCE Bangalore. At this stage, RVCE have the advantage. They have 90 points on the board, whereas IIT Delhi have 35. But things could change in the second half of this match. If both teams are ready, we'll start with the next starter for 10 points. What word meaning pulselessness in Greek describes unconsciousness or death caused by failure of the blood to become... Somebody's gone for it. Aditya from RVCE Bangalore.
Comatose.
It's not comatose, that's an interruption gone wrong, so 5 points taken away from your team total. It's 85, I'll complete the question for the other team. What word meaning pulselessness in Greek describes unconsciousness or death caused by failure of the blood to become properly oxygenated in the lungs? Push on from IIT Delhi.
Hemophilia.
No, the correct answer is asphyxia. A not sphysian to throb. So, here's the next starter for 10 for both teams. Which breed of dog, symbolic of aristocracy and whose likeness appears on an Egyptian tomb from 3000 BC, is the fastest running breed of dog? Is Arnab from IIT Delhi?
It's the greyhound.
It is the greyhound. 10 points to you. Well done. Your bonus questions, IIT Delhi, are linked by a word. In economics, what is defined as the measure of response of one variable to changes in another?
Correlation.
No, it's elasticity. Next, what is the common name of the plant Ficus elastica?
Rubber.
Rubber is the correct answer. Next, up to the elastic limit, the shape of a solid deforms in proportion to the stress applied, close quotes. By what name is this principle known?
Hooke's law.
Hooke's law is the correct answer, 5 points. Well done, IIT Delhi. Here's the next start of 10, open to both teams. According to the Valmiki Ramayana, whose parents cursed King Dashrath that he would die of lust of children? And it's Arnab from IIT Delhi.
Shravan Kumar.
Shravan Kumar is the right answer. 10 points. Well done. Bonus questions for you, IIT Delhi, on books of Dominic Lapierre and Larry Collins. Dominic Lapierre has co-authored 6 best-selling novels with Larry Collins. For 5 points, name any 3. For 10 points, name any 4. And for 15 points, name all 6. You have 6 attempts in all.
City of Joy.
That's wrong. City of Joy is not one of them.
Is New York burning? Is Paris burning?
Is Paris burning? Is correct.
Is New York burning?
Is correct.
Oh Jerusalem. It was 5 past midnight.
Oh Jerusalem.
Oh Jerusalem.
Correct. You get 5 points.
It was 5 past midnight.
No. You have one more attempt.
A thousand suns.
No, that's not correct. So you got just 5 points of that. Is New York burning? Is Paris burning? Or I'll dress you in the morning. Oh Jerusalem. Freedom at midnight. And the fifth horseman. With just 15 points separating the two teams, we're ready for the audio round. First clue here is a starter. Fingers on the buzzer, both teams. Which Irish boy band has re-sung this track? Uptown girl, she's been living in a rough. Yes, Aditya.
Is this Boyzone?
It's not Boyzone. Anybody on their side? Akshat from IIT Delhi.
This is Westlife.
It is Westlife. That is the correct answer. 10 points. IIT Delhi, you get a set of bonus questions on cover versions with clues on the soundtrack. Who sang this rock anthem originally performed by Guns N' Roses? Any idea?
ABBA.
ABBA. No, that's Sheryl Crow singing Sweet Child of Mine, which is a Guns N' Roses original. Re-sung by Boyzone. Who's the original artist of this song? What you can say, you have the answer?
Pass.
You don't know that. It's Tracy Chapman who sang Baby Can I Hold You Tonight. Next. Which group originally sang this number?
Hate you, don't be a fool.
The Beatles.
The Beatles is the correct answer. This, of course, was a cover version by Elvis Presley, which is unusual. But there it is. You pick up 5 points there. Here's the next starter open to both teams on the buzzer. Which Indian temple town, also called Arka Tirtha, derives its name from 2 words meaning corner and sun? And it's Arnab from IIT Delhi.
Konark.
Konark is the right answer. 10 points. Bonus questions for you, IIT Delhi, on terrorist attacks. Which organization claimed responsibility for assassinating Lord Louis Mountbatten in 1979?
The Sinn Féin.
It's not the Sinn Féin. It's the Provisional IRA. Or the IRA would have been good enough. Next. 3 members, Paul Alistair, Ross Dunn and Tim Anderson, of which organization were convicted of conspiracy but later pardoned in connection with the 1978 bombing outside the Sydney Hilton that hosted the Chogham Conference?
The Red Army.
It's not the Red Army, it's the Anand Marg. Next. For his part in which terrorist incident of 1985 was Inderjit Singh Rewat convicted to 5 years imprisonment?
The Kanishk bombings.
That is correct. 5 points to you for that. So you're now at 100, which is a century. But let's get on to the next starter for 10, open to both teams. Which planet's only moon is Charon? Whose diameter is Aditya from RVCE Bangalore?
Uranus.
No, that's incorrect, and that was an interruption, so 5 points taken away. Question passes. I'll complete the question for IIT Delhi. Oh, you've already gone for the buzzer. Pushon, do you have the right answer?
Mercury.
It's not Mercury either, so you blew that. The correct answer is Pluto. The question was, which planet's only moon is Charon, whose diameter is about half that of the planet? Okay, here's the next starter for 10, open to both teams. Which airline ran print ads with a copy, after a gap of 10 years, it's wonderful to be back, when it introduced non-stop flights from Delhi to Milan in 2004? It's Aditya from RVCE Bangalore.
Italia, Air Italia.
Say that again.
Air Italia.
Can't accept that. Anybody on the other side? IIT Delhi. Push on.
Alitalia.
That is the correct answer. 10 points. IIT Delhi, you get a set of bonus questions on newspaper columns. Which editor and talk show host writes a column in the Hindustan Times titled Counterpoint?
Veer Sanghvi.
That is the correct answer. 5 points. Who writes a sports column in the Indian Express titled Talking Sports?
Harsha Bhogle.
That is the correct answer. Another 5 points. Who writes a column in the Times of India titled Jugular Vein? Jagsaraya.
Jagsaraya.
That is the correct answer. You get 5 points for that. You bet at Cycle IT Delhi. You're now at 125. Here's the next starter for 10. Where did the agreement to respect the line of control resulting from the ceasefire of December 17, 1971? Let's push on from IIT Delhi.
Shimla.
Shimla is the correct answer. That's the agreement signed between Zulfikar Ali Bhutto and Indira Gandhi. And so IIT Delhi, you get a set of bonus questions on ancient water and land masses. What term did Alfred Wegener coin in 1912 when he tried to explain the observation that the shapes of continents on either side of the Atlantic Ocean seemed to fit together?
Pangaea.
No. The correct answer is continental drift. Next. What name meaning all lands in Greek is given to the supercontinent in the early Mesozoic era from which Laurasia and Gondwana were formed in the Jurassic period?
Pangaea.
This time it is Pangaea. Next. Which Greek goddess of oceans and mother of the Nile, Asia and many more, lent her name to the ancient ocean that existed between the landmass of Gondwana and Laurasia?
It's Gaia.
No, it's the Tethys Ocean or Sea. Next, starter, open to both teams on the buzzer. What kind of wheeled vehicle drawn by three horses abreast takes its name from the Russian word for three? It's Abhishek from RVC Bangalore.
Troika.
Troika is the right answer. 10 points to you. Well done. There's 2 minutes left on the clock. Your bonus questions are linked by a color. Which river called Al-Bahr al-Azak in Arabic and Abay in Amharic contributes almost 2/3 of the water of the Nile?
Blue Nile.
Correct. What term used to describe intellectual women in the mid-18th century is believed to have originated from Mrs. Vesey's reply when the learned Benjamin Stillingfleet declined her invitation to one of her parties because he lacked the appropriate dress?
Blue linen.
Not blue linen, blue stocking is the correct answer. Next, Blue Mountains National Park, the name referring to the striking bluish color of the mountains when viewed from a distance, is a rugged plateau region in which country?
South Africa.
No, it's Australia, New South Wales as a matter of fact. Here's the next starter for 10, open to both teams. Which composer's 1802 letter to his brothers that discussed his despair, in quotes, when one stood beside me and heard a flute in the distance and I heard nothing, close quotes, is known in history as a celebrated, it's Abhishek from RVC Bangalore.
Ludwig van Beethoven.
That is the correct answer, 10 points, well done. Bonus questions for you, RVC Bangalore, on military leaders. While Najibullah was the president of Afghanistan when the Taliban overthrew his regime, who was serving as the prime minister of the country?
Gulbuddin Hikmatyar.
It's correct, 5 points. While Robert Oakley, ex-US ambassador to Pakistan, led the American diplomatic initiative in Somalia in 1994, which ex-Somali ambassador to India opposed him militarily?
Pass.
Is Mohammad Aidid. Next. The Chechen warlord Shamil Basayev, who was involved in several hostage dramas in the 90s, was a military leader of the separatists in which region east of Chechnya?
North Ossetia.
No, it's Dagestan, which is the correct answer. The next starter for 10 for both teams. Who first became president of a country in 2001, retaining the presidency in the election of May 2004, defeating Fernando Poe Jr., a movie star? It's Akshat from IIT Delhi.
Is it Esmeralda Marcos?
It's not Esmeralda Marcos. Anybody from RVC Bangalore? Yes, Ashanka.
Gloria Arroyo.
That is the correct answer. 10 points to you. Well done. Bonus questions for you, RVC Bangalore, on Mongols. Which conqueror who ruled an empire extending from China to the Adriatic Sea was known by a name which meant? And that's time, it's Genghis Khan. And at the bell, time ran out for RVC Bangalore, who tried to put up a last minute search to recover the ground that they'd held till the first half of the contest. They wind up with 120, which is a brave effort and a good score, but not good enough to get ahead of IIT Delhi, who make it to the quarterfinals with 140 points. Congratulations to IIT Delhi for making it to the quarterfinals of University Challenge, and commiserations to RVC Bangalore, and thanks to them for having made a match of it. Next week, it's another quarterfinal match between Jipma Pondicherry and the Netaji Subhash Institute of Technology, Delhi, for a second round match. Until then, it's goodbye from RVC Bangalore.
Bye.
And it's goodbye from IIT Delhi.
Bye.
And it's goodbye from me, Siddhartha Basu. Goodbye.